होमवर्क है, फाइव वर्ड्स, फाइव वर्ड डिक्लेमेशन लाइक नदी, करेक्ट, पास इट सो, यू डू नो होमवर्क, वन है, excuses, excuses, excuses. Right, now you look at Nadi in your book. Look at Nadi in your book now. Nadi is feminine noun ending in E. Luckily, we don't have masculine. Now, together, now everybody say it. Two, three. So we see this nadi like in mati. In mati, it is short e, but at a couple places it becomes long, isn't it? In previous mati, which we had done, and nadi, it is long, but in one place it becomes short. Which place? 8 case singular. Okay, now say it after me. Look at the words in your page. Nadi. Nadyau, Nadyaha, Nadim, Nadyau, Nadihi, Nadya, Nadibhyam, Nadibhihi, Nadyaha, Nadibhyam, Nadibhyaha, Nadyaha, Nadyoho, Nadinam, Nadyam, Nadyoho, Nadishu. He Nadi, He Nadyau, He Nadyaha. Again by yourself now, 2, 3. Not clear here. Some people are mixing up also in pronunciation and all. Now say again after me. Nadi, Nadi. Nadyau, Nadyaha, Nadim, Nadyau, Nadihi, Nadya, Nadibhyam, Nadibhihi, Nadyaha, Nadibhyam, Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha. Nadyoho. Say it again. Nadyoho. Many people pronouncing that wrong. Nadyoho. Nadinam. Nadyam. Nadyoho. Nadishu. Hey Nadi. Hey Nadyav. Hey Nadyaha. Again, Nadi. Nadyav. Nadyaha. Nadim. Nadyav. Nadihi. Nadyam. Nadibhyam. Nadibhihi. Nadyaha. Nadibhyam. Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha. I'll leave out one. Fourth case. I say number three, two times. Nadiye. Nadiye. Nadibhyam. Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha. Nadibhyam. Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha. Nadyoho. Nadinam. Nadyam. Nadyoho. Nadishu. He Nadi. He Nadyav. He Nadyaha. Again. Nadi. Nadyav. Nadyaha. Nadim. Nadyav. Nadihi. Nadya. Nadibhyam. Nadibhihi. Nadyai. Nadibhyam. Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha. Nadibhyam. Nadibhyaha. Nadyaha. Nadyoho. Nadinam. Nadyam. Nadyoho. Nadishu. He Nadi. He Nadyav. He Nadyaha. Now by yourself all together. Two, three. Sixth and seventh dual is what? Dual. Say Nadyoho. So many people saying that wrong. Nadyoho. Again? Nadyoho. Again? 10 times. You don't know how much time you say it, so. All right. Now, today I'll do with you Sandhi. I'll give you examples in Visarga Sandhi. Visarga Sandhi, we started already. I gave you the chart. A chart for Visarga Sandhi. So, if the Visarga preceded by a
followed by a, or
a soft consonant. Just now.
Preceded by a, followed by a to o.
Or soft consonant.
Now what will happen to the visarga from the chart?
Avagraha.
What will happen to the visarga?
See the example. Visarga changes to O. Here? No. In this one it will happen. Here. Okay, now stop writing and you.
Followed by
subcontinent O.
Right, but you have called it R, to or here we say in R to or mm-hmm. is dropped.
Yeah, now I'll explain. But no, which one are you talking about?
No, this is R mm-hmm. followed by R. Mm-hmm. This is R. Mm-hmm. R followed by R to O.
Preceded by A.
Followed by R to O. It's dropped. And then it is preceded by R, followed by soft consonant, and then it's O. But there we're getting all of this becomes O.
In the first line, there's a drop also?
Yeah.
Just check with some of them chart and see if you had it correctly. I don't have a chart here to check that. Just now, eh? Yeah. Correct. Not R to O. Preceded by A, followed by A, changes to O. So we change it to O, yeah. Not R to O. Followed by A, changes to O. Then this will have to come here. Followed by A, here, or soft consonant. Get that? Not by A to O, but changes to, followed by A or soft consonant, changes to O. Yeah, sorry about that. But I'm going to show you now here. Please pay attention to this. Stop writing and look here. The rule says preceded by A, and followed by A or a soft consonant, it changes to O, right? So, nripaha rakshati, say? Will become, see, the visarga here is preceded by A. And here followed by soft consonant. I told you the semi-vowels are all soft. I told you that before, na? Yara la. What? They are all soft. So it is followed by a soft consonant. So it changes to O. So it becomes nripo rakshati. Get that? Now, see here now, it is a little bit different now. Ramha asti. It is preceded by A and followed by A. So, it becomes Ramo Asti. But I told you another rule at another time. See, that sandhi happens in two steps. Better go through the two steps, yeah? Okay, so preceded by A and followed by A. So it changes to Ramo Asti, right? But once this comes now, in Sanskrit there, you'll never see a phrase like this. There's a second sandhi which takes place there. It's called Avagraha Sandhi. This A
another rule, second rule, says when a is preceded by a or o, this a is preceded by a or o, that a, write down that rule, yeah? When a is preceded by a or o, or preceded by a or? O. So that is what is happening here. This a is preceded by what? This a is preceded by this o here. But that o came only because of the previous sandhi. Now the a becomes preceded by o. So it's either a or o. When a is preceded by a or o, the a is elided. Elided means dropped. The a is elided and an avagraha is written in its place. The a is elided and an avagraha is written in its place. So see here, this look here. This is elided and avagraha is written in its place like that. So you, in the literature, many times you will see that kind of little S thing like. That is the avagraha. So what has happened there, anytime you see that, all that has happened there is an has been dropped there. And always when that avagraha is there, there will be an A or an O before. See, here there is an O. This is the rule. So what happens in this case, in the case of, see here, nothing happens after there because there is no A following. But in this case now, the A is following and preceded by O. So a second sandhi takes place here. Two sandhis take place in this particular one, and here only one. Okay. And this is very common, actually. Very, very common. So when you're pronouncing this now, what do you say now? Here say, Ramo Asti.
Ramo Asti.
Ramo Asti.
Ramo Asti.
Ramo Asti is actually Ramaha Asti. Ramaha Asti. Rama is. Ramo Asti is after the first sandhi. Here now, Ramosti. Ramosti. Here? Ramo Asti. Again? Here? Again?
Ramosti.
Because people don't know this, some people don't know the sandhi, they pronounce this Ramo Asti. It is not Ramo Asti. It is Ramo Sti. Ramo Sti. This is Ramo Asti. But this is an incomplete. This is an incomplete line. That is a complete line. So when you see it in the literature, you pronounce it Ramo Sti. Ramo Sti. Yes. Namostute. You see? That will be now what? The original form of that will be what? Say. Namaha astu te means salutations to you. Namaha astu te. Namaha astu te will first become namo astu te. That's the first step. Namo astu te, because we follow this rule here. Just like. Then this, that, you get this. Namo astu te. Now, after that, you get namostu. Namostu te. Then namaste. Namaste is namahate. This namaste, which we normally say, Indian airline mascot. No? Namaste, namaste, namaste. That is actually namaha te. You will see that sandhi. That you will find. See, look for it there now. Visarga preceded by a and followed by any of the ta varga. Ta. Ta, ta, da, da. Ta, you have to look for ta. No, change will be there. Oops.
Which column is that? City column.
Sixth column. So here what happened? Visarga preceded by a and followed by ta or tha. You're seeing it? What happened to it? Change of sahalan. So there is sahalan there or not? So namaste is actually two words. Namaste, which we say all the time, is actually two words. Namaha, te. And that happened because of sandhi only there, which was, you know, you have the rule. The first time in your life now you understand namaste. Namaha, te. And I told you one more rule about namaha. What is that rule? Govern the fourth case, correct. That means this te is fourth case. It has to be fourth case. Te is actually fourth case of Yushmad Shabda, it is called. I have not given in class yet, but that is fourth case. Fourth case means, in that word, Yushmad, the second, fourth, and sixth cases, they have an alternative. Te is the alternative in fourth case. So this te here is actually fourth case. When we get there, you'll see. But anyway, so now that's how you get namaste. It's by following the same rule we are just using here. because it is preceded by visarga, and this we have special tantha becomes sa halan. So anyway, now Ramaha asti will become Ramosti. Ramosti. Okay. I think those two examples, these are only two examples you will get. Either it is followed by a soft consonant or it is followed by a. Then if it is followed by any other vowel from O, from A to O all the way down in the N, it will drop. This is the second column which you have, right? It will drop. Musti. Preceded by A, followed by any other vowel except A. That is the next one. Preceded by A, followed A to O. This is number two now. Preceded by A, followed by any of the other vowels from A to O all the way down to the end. It is dropped. See, in those two sentences now, you can do easily. In all three cases, see, it will drop. It means over here you can put an equal sign and just drop the visarga. Now say this. Vrityaha agachati. Vrityaha agachati. Balaha Ichchati. Balaha Ichchati. Bhikshukaha Unchati. Bhikshukaha Unchati. Bhrityaha Agachati means the servant comes. The servant comes. So Bhrityaha Agachati will become Bhritya Agachati. You have to leave out the visarga. Balaha Ichchati will become Bala Ichchati. Bala Ichchati. And means the boy desires. The boy wants. And Bhikshukaha Unchati. The beggar. It will become Bhikshuka Unchati. The beggar gathers or collects. Huh? Alms, alms. What do you collect? Gather up alms or collects alms like that. unchati. So in all cases, if sarga will drop there. Okay, now pay attention to this. Preceded by a and followed by any other vowel except a means from a to o all the way down, or whichever, right? That will drop. So then you will get bhritya agachati, bhritya agachati, right? This is the result. But remember when we are doing Ramaha Asti, it becomes Ramo Asti, and then there is a second step also, it becomes Ramosti. Now here, this ends with what? And this is followed by A. Now there is a second rule that says A plus A is what? So don't write this down, according to the rule which we had done before, A plus A is A, you will get this, isn't it? But in this particular sandhi here, you have to take a note. The resultant words do not combine, that by rule. The resultant words do not combine, meaning to say what? This is the resultant here, isn't it? Bhritya agachati. By rule, you cannot combine it and get this. Ordinarily, if no sandhi had taken place, you could combine those two words. You understand that? And there is a the rule is necessary because of something else now. That all the other thing you will study on. Because this here, these are two separate words. One word lost its visarga because of the sandhi rule. This word lost its visarga because of the sandhi rule. So these are two separate words. This is a compound. This is a compound, and compound is a whole different topic altogether. So you can't combine the two. The rule says that the resultant words cannot be combined. So you make sure you put that note. It means when that visarga is dropped, So that is what you will get there only. You are not allowed any further step. The boy desires or he wants. Balaha ichchati. He desires or he wants. Right. No, number three. Preceded by a and followed by any vowel or soft consonant, what will happen? It dropped. A followed correct? Let's check the chart. No examples. Okay, now look here. So, Harihi Asti, say? So, what happens there? It is preceded by what? Not a. Preceded by? This visarga is preceded by? Visarga is preceded by E. Hari, the E. So, preceded by any vowel except A or A. So, preceded by E. So, what will happen? Followed by any vowel or soft consonant. Now, it's followed by A. So, it will change to Rahalan. So, this is what you'll get. Harir Asti. Now, in this case, these two will join. Just now, some other rule I had told you that two cannot join. In this case, these two will join. So what you will get? Harirasti. You will get Harirasti. Rasti. Because this Ra halan and this A is there, the two of them will. So the A will be gone inside that Ra there. So here, same thing will happen because there's an A. Here, nothing will happen because this is not an A. You'll get Agnir Dahati. Agnir Dahati. But then this Ra, will become Raif on the top here. It's not joining. It just becomes a Raif. So you'll get like this. This Ra comes on the top here, because that's Ra Halan. Everybody looking like this is some strange thing. This Ra is Ra Halan, na? And this is Ra Halan here or not? So it just goes on the top. So the word joins, but no vowel has gone into the Ra. The Ra still remains Ra Halan. Okay, you write it down. Next week I'll do some more explanation. There's more there. There's more explanation there. Here, at the bottom, these two, something else will happen. Some other thing will happen there.